To define an orthographic camera in 3.js, you do two operations. One is to define a volume and space, the other is to move and orient that volume of space as you wish. This first piece of code creates the orthographic camera and defines the rectangular box of space it's viewing. This box is defined by the left-to-right width limits, the top-to-bottom height limits, and front-to-back limits, all in world space coordinates. These correspond to the x, y, and z axes. The camera can be thought of being positioned on the plus z end of the box defined, looking down the minus z axis, with up being the y plus direction as usual. For convenience, I define a view size, which is how much vertical space I'd like to fit in the view. The aspect ratio is just that, what's called the aspect ratio of the window. It describes how wide the view is compared to how high it is. For example, if your view was 1,000 pixels wide and 500 high, the aspect ratio would be equal to 2. In other words, you'd want your box to be twice as wide as it is tall. If you don't, you'll get a stretched view of the world, which is probably not what you wanted. What all this code does is defines a box in space. In this case, it happens to be centered around the origin. By the way, I've seen some demos just use the canvas width and height directly as the camera's size. Don't do this. You're setting the camera's size in your scene in world coordinates, which is most definitely not the same as the width and height of your canvas in pixels. If we stopped here and put our drinking bird in the scene, we'd get a side view of the bird. What we'd now like to do is position and orient this camera in space to make a more interesting view. This code does that. The first line moves the box by this amount. It's a translation, the same as for a normal object. The camera controls code does two things. First, it sets up what sort of mouse controller you want for the camera, if any. I came up with this custom Orbit and Pan Controls class, extending the Orbit Controls class I found in 3.js. This control keeps the camera oriented so that the plus y axis is always up. For a more unconstrained but trickier to use control, the Trackball Controls class could be specified instead. In either case, the next line sets the target for the camera. The target is the location being looked at. This defines a new z-axis direction for the camera. The y-axis is kept pointing up as best as possible. We'll talk about that later when we look at the matrices forming this camera. Once we've positioned this box in space, it defines what part of the scene we want to render. Whatever happens to be inside this box is what we'll see on the screen. The z-buffer is applied as usual so that objects that are closer to the camera cover up what's behind them. This is just an overview of the basic idea. The camera defines a chunk of space defining its limits, and this chunk then gets positioned and oriented in space to make an image. I'll go over this process in detail in the following lessons.